The epistle reading comes from Paul's letter to the Christians in Corinth, second letter to the Christians in Corinth, chapter 5, verse 17 through 20. Paul writes, "If anyone is in Christ, there is a new creation. Everything old has passed away. See, everything has become new. All this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ and has given us the ministry of reconciliation. That is, in Christ, God was reconciling the world to himself, not counting their trespasses against them, and entrusting the message of reconciliation to us. So we are ambassadors for Christ, since God is making his appeal through us." The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
This is our next meeting on our beloved community. I have a dream that one day on the Red Hills of Georgia, the sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners will be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood. I have a dream that one day, even the state of Mississippi, a state sweltering in the heat of injustice, sweltering in the heat of oppression, will be transformed into an oasis of freedom and justice. I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but rather by the content of their character. I have a dream today. I have a dream that one day down in Alabama, little black boys and little black girls will be able to join hands with little white boys and little white girls as sisters and brothers. I have a dream today. Let us fight passionately and unrelentingly for the goals of justice and peace. But let's be sure that our hands are clean in this struggle. Let us never fight with falsehood and violence and hate and malice, but always fight with love, so that when the day comes that the walls of segregation have completely crumbled in Montgomery, that we will be able to live with the people as their brothers and sisters. The end is reconciliation. The end is redemption. The end is the creation of the beloved community. It is the type of spirit and this type of love that can transform opponents into friends. It is this type of understanding, goodwill, that will transform the deep gloom of the old age into the exuberant gladness of the new age. It is this love which will bring about the miracles in the hearts of men.
As Sue plays our introduction to our next hymn, there are some youth in the congregation who are armed with staplers. And I have asked them to come around and help you join your prayer strips, your personal prayers, into a prayer chain, the prayers of this community gathered together. Because together as a community, our prayers have power and are effective. So let us sing and let us pray.